गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय नमो नमस्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मानतोऽस्मि त्वैवास्मि त्वैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नयमाम् भक्त्या विहीना अयपराधलक्ष्यै कीर्तास्य कामा दितरङ्गमध्ये कृपामयीं त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दं वृन्दे नमस्ते चरणारविन्दं We begin from the first canto, first slok. Now you have entered in 10th canto Srimad Bhagavatam. Oh, Krishna is coming. Oh, so Krishna is coming and you will be, don't weep. Don't weep. Krishna is coming and he will play with you. He is searching, so don't weep. Krishna is coming. At once Krishna will come. So be ready to see Krishna. How beautiful he is. Perhaps you know the pastime of Krishna. How Krishna took birth in Mathura and how he was exchanged in Gokul. How Vasudev Maharaj tried to save Devaki, mother Devaki, his wife. So you know something about, but I want that you should help me in telling these stories, and I will tell some deep things. Who can narrate well? You? You can tell?
Which story?
Krishna's birth?
How Krishna came in the womb of Devaki, what happened, what was the correct form, everything. Up to going to Gokul. And then I will tell some deep meanings and the teachings.
I can do Gurudev, but I'm very embarrassed.
Stand up and you should come here. Not there, come here. So that all can. You should laugh first, then.
Vasudeva and Devaki were in the jail of Kamsa because he heard the prophecy from this guy that is the eighth child of Devaki would kill Krishna. So the seventh child...
Kamsa.
Kamsa. With kill Kamsa. So the seventh child was transferred to the womb of Rohini, and the eighth child, when he appeared in the dungeon in the form of Vishnu, and then Vasudeva and Devaki offered their prayers, and Devaki finally asked that the Lord change himself into a small child so that she could try to protect him. Then by the Lord's mystic powers, the gatekeepers went to sleep and the doors opened, and Vasudev carried Krishna on his head.
Vasudev. There is so difference in Vasudev and Vasudev.
Who is
Vasudev?
Vasudev.
Vasudev Maharaj is the father of Vasudev.
Vasudev means Krishna, Vasudev means...
Yes, Vasudeva. Vasudev is himself Krishna.
Vasudev is Krishna.
Vasudev himself was the father of Krishna.
So he carried Krishna. towards Gokula, and then in a basket. And it was raining and storming. And so in the middle of the Jamuna, he dropped Krishna. And so my understanding is that point, the mother Jamuna brought Krishna of Gokula out, and Vasudev of Mathura disappeared. So then he carried and transferred with the girl that was born of Yasoda, who was Yogamaya, and then he carried her back to Mathura, where Kamsa found out about the baby and tried to kill her, and was unsuccessful because she fell out of her hand and went up into the sky and called Kamsa a fool. Then the next day there was the wonderful birth ceremony of Sri Krishna. And all the inhabitants of Gokula were so much happy. And by your mercy, I was able to go and visit Gokula and see these wonderful spots. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Anything more? You can tell? Anything more?
You want me to tell more, Mark?
Yes. Anything? Hidden beginning?
No, I'll just stick with that story.
You can give some more, except. Here in ninth, up to ninth canto. Parikshit Maharaj becomes so happy. An unhappy boy. Up till now he has not heard the glories of Krishna. What he wanted, but he has heard the glories of so many devotees of Krishna. So he was satisfied, but not full satisfied. In the ninth canto, in the last, he told Krishna, asked Sukadeva Goswami, I want to hear the glories of Krishna. How he became? He is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But why he came in the womb of Devaki? And why he went to Gokul and was exchanged with the girl of Yashoda? What he did there? And again he returned to Mathura and again went to Dwarka. So I want to hear something from you. He becomes so pleased, Sukadeva Goswami. And he remembered all these things, what Dasdev has seen in his samadhi. How Krishna took birth, how he did in Gokul, and all pastimes of Krishna. He is overjoyed that he is going to tell me the pastimes of Krishna. So he is telling in his sloka, Nivrtatarshai rupagiyamanat bausadhatsrotrimanobhirama kahuttam sloka gunanubhadat virajyet vinapasubhna. He is telling that. You have told the devotees, especially in the dynasty of Sun dynasty and Chandra dynasty, Moon dynasty. And Yadu was so fortunate that in his dynasty Krishna came, because he did not obey his father. His father was telling that you should give me your young age and take my old age. I want to test the young age with so many wives, children and my family. But now I am old, I cannot test. He refused. Then he became angry and told that yourself and any boy, son, or any one of your dynasty will never be a king. All this like common general persons. He was so happy. Yes, I admit, no harm. So Krishna saw that he will have to come here in this world for so many reasons to establish Yuga Dharma. What was the Yuga Dharma? Yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyuttanam adharmasya. Swadhana parishanaya sadhunam vinashaya cha dushyata sadhanarthaya swamnuvamihe. So I come to establish Yuga Dharma. And that yuga was now going to be end. So many demons in the shape of kings, Kshatriya kings, everywhere in the world where they were. And they were disturbing. So they became so weight on Prithvi Devi. Burden, so much burden. Any weight cannot disturb Prithvi, Bhudevi. But only the sinful acts, sinful person, they become so much burden for. So this thing was. Secondly, he wanted to vinodaya bhaktanam. Bhaktanam vinodaya sha. Why he wants to come to protect sadhu and vinashayata duskitam? What is the meaning? Any bona fide devotee never calls Krishna or Supreme Personality of Godhead or anyone that I should be saved. Never. We don't want, we don't fear for death. We are always ready to embrace death. Because I have been of 76, so I know that I, in this body, I cannot do any shagan. Not so. Pachan and sadhan bhajan I cannot do. So if death is coming to give me new body, new energy, why I should not do it? So I should embrace. I'm not fearing from anything. What suffering, sorrows may come, but I know that it will never come. Like Narad Rishi, he put his feet, grew up, kept his feet on the head of death. So Vaishnava never care for this. So why he should pray to Krishna that you should come and save me from death and all sufferings? Never. But he is eager to serve Krishna. He is feeling what separation. So much according to the degree of devotion, several kinds of bhakta, they are feeling separation for Krishna. So, to vinodaya, to please all the bhaks. So, to play with bhaks and to taste dasharas, shakharas, vasandaras and madharas. This is vinodaya. To play with all. Especially he will play with his own associates. But by this they will distribute, Krishna will distribute whole pain to whole world. So this was one thing. And he wanted to taste some rush also. What rush? Especially that he has never tasted this Singha rush. In the day of Brahma, he has never come with gopis and gops and braja. So he will come here and test here, and he will मैं अपने ये छोड़ जाएंगे अपने बाद में उनकी कथाओं को. He will
keep his first time.
What? Krishna will go, his all associates go, but yet here Hari Katha will past time will be here. For thousand and lakhs years, and those who will hear, those who will tell, all will have this dream. So anugrahaya bhaktanam manushi tam ashritam, to what? Anugrahaya,
to give mercy.
To give mercy. What mercy? What he will play with gops and gopi brajavasi, it will for here. And if anyone hear this, they will at once be purified and they will go to Golok Vrindavan. Also, the places where he has played, if anyone go, like Radha Kund, Shyam Kund, Banshivat, Bhandirvat, Nandagaon, Varsana, anywhere where Krishna has played this, pastimes, any man go and keep his head there and keep in the dust of lotus feet, dust of gopis and gopis and Krishna. They'll be purified and they will have easily Krishna prem, which is very rare for a Brahma, Narad, Sukadeva and others. So, Parikshit Maharaj, so Krishna wants to come, he is waiting for the time, actual time, for all these things. When Brahma with Prithvi, with Earth, in the shape of cow, he went to Brahma and Shiva's weeping. And then Brahma with Shankar and all other demigods with cow went to the coast. Shwetdeep, and he was remembering him. Brahma realized something. A vibration from sky was coming, and he heard that. Don't be worried. I know everything. What you have told, I know before. Don't worry, worry for this. My Prabhu has known this. My Prabhu means?
Master.
My Lord.
Who is telling? Garbhodashai. And who is his master? Krishna himself. So master has known all these things. And he has taken decision that I said go in Prithvi, Bolo, in Vrindavan, Mathura. And he has ordered that you should all, demigods, should go and take birth in Yadav Kul, dynasty of Yadav. And your wives, they should also go to serve Priya Arthe. Priya Arthe, Priya Arthe. Very beautiful Sanskrit word. Priya Arthe means to serve Krishna. And Priya Arthe, Priya means Radha, Priya, Priya to serve Srimati Radhika. You should all go there and wait. I myself with my power, energy, with Srimati Radhika will appear there. Why? Krishna is thinking that once upon in Satyayug, Diti and Kashyap and Aditi, they did hard studies. When Narayan came in front of him, them, and he told that what benediction you want. They told that you should come like anyone should come like you as a mission. I want that a son should be me. I have like you, so much qualified. He told there is no one like me in this world. So I'll have to come. He promised. In the meantime, another bhakta, Drona and Dhara. Drona means the king of mountains, Drona, father of Himalayas. With his wife, Dhara, this Prithvi Devi, Bhu Devi. They did hard studies, more than Vasudeva and Diti and Kashyap. After a long time, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he came and asked, what you want? Have any benediction? He told Drona that, please ask my wife. And what he will say, I'm agreed to reply. Point. She told that, I want to love you as a son. this prem should be given to me and my husband. Basalya prem for you. He did not want a son, but he wanted to serve Krishna like father and mother. Actually, this prem, first topic of prem she wanted. Yes, I will be there like your son. Now, so many reasons. Astartes of Drondhara, Astartes of Kashyap, Aditi, and the Dugdharma. And in the meantime, Prithvi Devi, Bhu Devi, with Brahma and Shankar, they all went to Swetdeep and pray that you should come and save me from these demon kings. Also, he has to fulfill the wish of daughter of Bali Maharaj. Who was she? Ratna?
Ratnamala.
Ratnamala. When Krishna came in the shape of Vamandev and he wanted to cheat Bali Maharaj, very beautiful boy. Very beautiful. But his shape was so small. But very lovely and charming. When this boy went there, she saw the daughter of Bali Maharaj and she had a desire that, oh, I like that he should be my son. Vamandeva at once, Krishna knew this and told her, yes, I will be your son. But when Krishna, Vamandeva began to take gradually earth, whole Brahmand, and he took him, Bali Maharaj himself, kept his foot on his head and took himself also. And he binded him and threw on the ground. And he began to weep. The daughter, Ratnamala, was upset. Oh, at first, seeing his beauty, I was so much affectionate. So I thought that he should be my son. But now, if he will come like my son, I will give him poison, very hard poison, and he will put to death. He accepted Brahman, yes, I also, you should come like this, I will fulfill your desire. So there are so many reasons, not only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, what reasons more? Ramchandra went with Lakshman to Janakpuri, Mithila, and he married Sita Devi there. All the friend girls of Sita Devi wanted to marry Ramchandra, and they have a wish hidden in their heart that, oh, we want that Ram should be my husband. Yes, but not this time. In Dwarka, in Dwapar Yuga, you will be like gopis and then I will fulfill your wish. To satisfy them, to give them the rejection to them. And especially the Koto Dandakar, Koto Rishi, Shat, 60,000 rishis were doing aradhana to have Krishna in gopi mood, that he should be your pati, husband. So they were doing, but like us, not regularly and not so, but attached. Sometimes one round, sometimes two rounds, sometimes nothing, like this, like laziness. But when they saw Ram, they became so much inspired. I think that when I was not here, all were not so enthusiastic. But when here, all are now inspired. Some are dancing, doing kirtan and all things. I think properly chanting, hearing Hari Katha daily. So, they become very enthusiastic. And they prayed Ramchandra that we want to be like gopis and serve you. Because tatpatah they are both one. Ramchandra told that, I have none your heart. In Dwapar Yug, in the last of Dwapar Yug, I will be Krishna. And there you will be gopi, I will fulfill your all wishes. You know the history of Sita Devi. In the end of Ram Leela, Ram gave up Sita forever. Lakshman took him in forest, and near the forest, near the ashram of Valmiki, he left and told that Ram has given you forever. He will not take you. She at once fell flat and began to weep so loudly. And Lakshman, in his faint stage, he left that place and he returned. So sadly, Sita was weeping so much. After that, Valmiki Rishi came there and told, oh, my dear darling daughter, I know everything. Come with me in my ashram. And for remaining your life, you should be with me. I know that you have two sons in your home. There will be very pathetic scene, and in the end you will meet with Ram. So wait here in my ashram. She began to live there. In woman's quarter, there were sort of two quarters. Female devotees, lady devotees, and male devotees. After some time, Lokush was burned. They took birth. And they were trained by Sita and Valmiki himself. He taught them Valmiki Ramayana. No? And Sita was there. Ram was very much feeling separation for Sita Devi. He was in the palace, but he ate on chatai, mat on floor. He was like same as Sita was in forest, not taking anything like Sita. Sita has some sleep with his voice, but he had never sleep, always lamenting and feeling separation from him. There was no one to
console him.
But here, the two boys, two sons and Valmiki, they were helping her to be consoled. They were consoling her. So Ram was much more disturbed. He wanted to do a yajna, fire sacrifice, Ashwamedha yajna, and he was doing, but Valmiki, Vasishtha told that you cannot do any sacrifice without Sita. You can marry another lady. He told that I will never. Then Ramchandra told that I will have to do. So anyhow you should tell how to do. He told that you can bring Sita from forest, or it is absent. Make anything else. He told that you should establish a Swarna Sita, golden Sita. And with her, you should do sacrifice. He did it, and he did Pran Pratishtha himself, with the help of Vasishtha. If Ramchandra ji doing himself Pran Pratishtha with the help of Vasishtha, so high class of priest, Sita Devi became alive.
She became present.
Yes. Actually, this was not now a vigraha only, but she was like that, Sita. When once Lakshman, Lava and Kush went to the fire sacrifice of Ramchandra and they were singing so very beautiful way. They are very beautiful like Ram, not less than Ram, but now they were a child of 8 and 9, so beautiful more, and so sweet voice. And with Veena, they were singing Valmiki Ramayana. All were moved. Even Ram began to weep. Lakshman began to weep. Kausalya Devi, all the monkeys, Hanuman, Sugriva, all were began to weep. Varsatrugna also, Kaikeyi also. Ramchandra ordered Lakshman that go to that voice and tell who are they? Who is the father and mother of these two boys? And give them so much gold and things,
golden
coins and everything. And so silk and cloth made of gold sometimes.
Royal
dress like. Then Lakshman went to the boys and told that, oh boys, what is the name of your father and mother? Lokus told very
politely.
We knew that you are a very learned person. You know all Ved, Upanishad and everything. But your question is not good. Anyone should not ask the caste, the name of father, mother of any brahmachari. They can only ask, who is your Gurudev? The designation is only Gurudev. So don't also ask the name and father and mother's name, caste name, from where you are coming. These are silly questions, bogus questions. But we ask like this, anyone ask, your father is now alive, or he has died. Where you took birth? Don't ask only. Don't disturb them. So he flatly told him, that why you are asking like this? You are a very learned person. He becomes ashamed. Then he told that, we are the disciple of Valmiki. And they believe he is my Gurudev and we have learned everything from him. Then he told that Ramchandra, the king, emperor of this place, he wants to give you something. And he presented it in a golden pot, so many coins full of, so good Rashmi Vastra and everything. And when he was presenting to them, they told simply, we need nothing. We are simply Brahmachari. We don't want gold and all these things. What we will do? Everything, all kinds of fruit are there. We have hands to take.
Water
and anything, we take only fruits there. There is plenty of fruits there. Everybody is going home, Ganges. We know nothing. We don't need cloths. Only we take the cloths made by the leaves of plantain tree. Balkal Vastra, nothing we want. Then he became so wondered. How beautiful these boys are and how strong in philosophy, their philosophy. He returned. They returned to their mother in the Valmiki ashram and told, what told? She was weeping and waiting eagerly for their two sons. Today was some late. She came. He saw Lava and Kush and told Ramesh, my sit down. And then she told, my dear boys, he took one boy here, one boy here. And like this, I was waiting so eagerly for you, it became late. Why became late? They told, mother, we have gone to a king's court, courtyard. Concert. And we were singing there. Valmiki Ramayana. And the king himself, the mother of kings, the brother, and whole council was waiting. And we saw a very wonderful thing, mother, there. So it became there. What? There was a statue of gold, golden statue. We were wondered that statue was like, totally like you. You are speaking and that was not speaking, only this was the difference. But same like this. Hearing this, Sita began to be bitterly. They astonished that, why my mother is now waiting to hear this? Sita was thinking, Ram had not left me, but he is queen. I'm always with him because he has taken my this statue with him. So he cannot. So I'm there. Ram is also loving still to me. But I cannot meet him. And he felt so suppressed and began to weep bitterly. Then Lord Kush with one hand they began to wash
the white tears.
But they were not imagining also that why my mother is so weeping. So when Ram was going to despair his pastimes, Sita, Sharma Sita, not only Sita one, but each year he used to do.
Everywhere.
And new Sita were established. So all Sita told that, what will be of, will have to be always with you? He told that, yes. But when I will be Krishna, in the opposite, you all be gopi, and I will fulfill your all desires. So for all reasons, Krishna was waiting that when a time will come that I will go to this world. So many reasons. I cannot. Surpanakha was also that cause. Surpanakha has told that I have given my heart to you, to Ramchandra. I want to marry you. Ramchandra told that I am married, you should go to my younger brother. Younger brother told that you want to be queen or servant. He told, I want to be queen. So why you are marrying me? I am only a servant. And if you are marrying me, I will marry you, but you will be dasi, maid servant. Why you don't want not to be a king? Queen? So go to Ram and try to marry him. Again she went to Ram. Ram again sent to Lakshmana. Lakshman again sent to him. And thus she was disturbed and he wanted to take Sita in his mouth and to swallow. When it went to Sita to catch, Ram shot towards Lakshman and don't make any joke with any lady. Be very grave. Otherwise, they will come to your head. And they will make a stool here. And you will be finished. Don't joke. So he took a sharp
sword.
And he took up his
face. Nose and ear.
She became happy. And at once went to Ram. Why Ram did it? Because she had told that I have given my heart to you. I want to marry you. Ram is Vanchakalpataru. Panchakalpatru, you know?
Exactly.
He must accept him, her. So he accepted. But it will take time to do like that. So he made ugly that anyone should not love her. Because now she is ugly, and in the next birth she became kubja. That anyone can marry and don't, anyone cannot love her. And then Krishna will come and he will
make her beautiful.
Beautiful, so much beautiful, and then she will marry Krishna. Or she will be loved by him. Krishna will fulfill his desire. Though his love and affection was not qualified, bona fide, or third class bogus, one it enjoys, not like gopis and Dwarkavas. Mahishi. But yet, Krishna cannot deny. Anyone who goes to Krishna, he will not deny. If anyone is giving his heart one pence, a fraction of dollar, then he will give fraction of his devotion to them. Ye jathang mam prapadyante tam tathaiva bhajamyaham. You know this slok. Any devotee, a fraction he is giving something, he will give him fraction. Those who will give whole, Krishna will go give his whole. He will go to only whole to gopis, not anyone. Madhav Karna Shat. By whole senses and whole body and mind and everything. Only gopis. So, to fulfill the desire of Surpana Khahi was to come. Oh, don't remember me. Otherwise, 2, 3, 4 days will be. Tell the causes of why Krishna came. So many causes. But I have touched them. So Krishna was bound to come, but when he will come? When Brahma with cows prayed on this bank of Swet Deep, oh yes, I am coming soon. He did not reply. Who replied? Garbhodasai. My master has, because he was the master of Brahma. Sahasra Sisha, Vishnu. Garbhodasai, coming from the? So he prayed to him. Brahma has nothing to do with the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, Nanda Nanda. Only he can reach to up to that. Then he, Garbhodasai thought, I cannot do all these things. So he prayed to his master, oh Krishna himself. Krishna told that, tell Brahma that they should be ready, I am coming. Just very soon. Then you know the history of Sushen. Time came, last of Dwapar Yug. There was a king Sushen in the dynasty of Jadu. He has two wives. One Kshatriyani and other milkmaid. From the dynasty of Gopi, Nand Baba, Parjanna, the father of Nand Baba, and Nand Baba came. This is also Jadu Bansh. And also second came from Parjanna, Ajamir, then Sursen, and then Vasudev. And from Vasudev, Krishna came. So Krishna came in two ways. In the midnight, he came in the shape of Chaturbhuj Narayan from Devaki and Vasudeva. And he fulfilled the desire of Diti and Kashyap and Aditi. And at the same moment, in the midnight, Krishna came in the womb of Yashoda. And from there, two children came. One came himself, Supreme Personality of Godhead. And after some time, half an hour or 15 minutes, a girl came. That is Yoga Maya. In Srimad Bhagavat, it has not written in the beginning all these things. Like Swamiji has told all these things. But after that, sometime, he disclosed all these matters. Understand? Disclose? Why he was telling that he took birth in Mathura Malli from the womb of Devaki? There was some reason. This reason was that Parikshit Maharaj was son of Abhimanyu. Abhimanyu the son of Arjuna. And also came in the womb of Subhadra, the sister of Krishna. Also Kunti was the brother, sister of Vasudeva Maharaj. And she was married to Pandu. And from Pandu and Kunti, Arjun was there. And from Arjun, Abhimanyu. And from Abhimanyu, Parikshit Maharaj. So he was related to Dwarkadhish Krishna and Pandavas. So he has an ego, that I am in the dynasty of Pandavas. And from the dynasty, sister of Krishna, Vasudeva. So he wanted to please Parikshit Maharaj that Krishna has come in your dynasty. Very near relation he was showing. To make some attachment with Krishna. And that, knowing that if I will tell like this, he will be more happy. That Krishna has come in our dynasty. And partly it is true. Here we will have to see that no difference in Godness, Tattva, Krishna Tattva. Krishna, Ram, Balaram, all the manifestations are same up to Mahavishnu, Garbhodasai, Khirodasai. All are same, Tattva, Narayan, everyone. But by rush, you know, Rashen Utkrishyate Krishna, Rukmesha Rasasthiti. By rush, when we will discuss about rush, then Krishna is certainly supreme. Nishing cannot be father. No? He cannot be. Ram, partly Aswarja and partly Madhur. He has so many friends. So many servants, like Hanuman, but no one is friend of Madhur Bhava. No? He has so many friends. He has servants like Hanuman, but Hanuman cannot embrace Ram. He cannot give his remnants to Ram. When Ram is with Sita in the palace, there Hanuman cannot go. Anyone cannot go. Lakshman, Bharat, Shatrughna, also the king of Nishad Raj, Sugriva, and Vibhishan were friends of Ram. But always like servant, not like friend. Anyone cannot sit on the shoulder of Ram. They cannot give their eminence. They cannot fight with Ram. They cannot defeat. They cannot imagine all these things. But Sridham Subal, how they are? They can defeat Krishna. They can get remnant taking out from here. They are taking very delicious thing, anything. And they will take this and they will give in the mouth of Krishna. They will play with Krishna and tell them, oh, I want that you should be my horse. Yes, very good. And he will be horse and Sridham will ride over his feet. And he will tell that, dul dul, Go on. Huh? Why you are not running so much? My horse is not so good. Please. Any friends of Ram cannot do this. Only half vatsal is there. If there is Madhur Rash, Swakiya Madhur Rash, he may tell that Sita, I am giving up you for whole life. But in Dwarka, he cannot do like this. But he can control. If he were not
obeying me.
No. If he was not want to hear the glories of gopis and gops of Braja, I'll get out of my kingdom. At once. I've married you only for gopis.
Amen.
And I'm telling the glories of gopis, you are becoming some
jealous.
Upset. So if you are being upset, at once I will take you from my palace. And they were controlled again, like hearing. And in gopis, if Krishna will, cannot tell them. If Krishna will tell anything, they will tell that you should at once go far from our groups. At once, we don't see, want to see any black, even black colored sari, like hairs, like bees,
bumblebees.
We don't want to see any black thing. Black are internally black and all outwardly black. I know you are very liar, cheater. We don't have any relation with you, go out. And then Krishna will tell, oh, I have done wrong. Excuse me. So by this rush, Krishna being the super personality of Godhead. But here, he is controlled by Yashoda. Yashoda tells, oh, don't come to me. I will never take you in my life. And then he becomes weeping. Mother, mother, I want you. And to gopis, begging pardon and everything. So by this way, in Krishna is everything. Shant, Das, Shakya, Varsalya, Madhu, even Harsya, Karuna, Raudra, Bhayana, Vivas, 12 Varasas. Ram only half, two and half. Narayan, two and half. In Krishna, Dwarkadish, only three. And not full, three, four. No Madhur Rash, half. No Vatsalya Rash there, only half. Not half yet. Not like Yashoda and Nanda Baba, their Vatsalya is very mixed with opulence, that is Aishwarya. It cannot control Krishna. Those who are reading Chaitanya Charitamrita, 1 hour. So, very beautiful things. So, Krishna is more superior in Rasa and Shakti. Ram has Karuna Rasa. Karuna means? But Krishna has all. And in supremacy. Vatsalya Rasa, more than Devaki, Vasudev, Dasarath, Kausalya, or anybody. So the pastimes of Krishna, all supreme. So Krishna is supreme personality of Godhead. So there is also difference between Yashodanandan and Devakinandan. In the last of Srimad Bhagavata it has been told. But Devaki Janma Bhado. What is love? Jati Jananivaso Devaki Janma Bhado Jadubar Parsap Sai Dharubhirashanna Dharman. Really, Krishna is the son of Yashoda. I have it. He is telling. For Sukadeva Goswami. To Parikshit Maharaj. Those who tell that he is son of Vasudeva Devaki, it is partly true. So those who like Mathura and those who like Brajavasi, gopis, Vrindavan, they will never admit that he is partly son of Devaki and Vasudeva. Only for lower caste class of devotees it is there. To make them gradually develop and to know all these very deep things. So we'll have to tell that Krishna took birth in Mathura. And he took his son to go. For whom? For Akru, to satisfy Parikshit, those who are Dwarkadhish associates to satisfy. But if you will tell this in Vrindavan, what they will do? They will flip slabs. If you will tell him to Yashoda Mehberi, then he will take your this like this. If you will tell any gopis, then Madhumangal, Sudam, Suval, Nand Baba, then what they will tell? Either they will cry and they will tell them, oh, laugh. So, for all these reasons, Krishna came. And there is supremacy of the son of Yashoda Nandan. He Krishna Karuna Sindho, Dina Bandho Jagatpate, Gopesha Gopika Kanta, Radha Kanta Namaste. And the last Radha Kanta Namaste. First beginning from Krishna from Mathura, son of Devaki. He Krishna, he is Karuna Sindhu, Dina Bandhu, Jagatpate. Who? Devaki Nandan. But after that, Gopesha, not Yashoda. Gopesha. Who is? Yashoda Nandan, Nanda Nandan. Gopesha, moreover, Gopika Kanta, moreover, go on. Radhakant, here he is satisfied. So, gradually you will come to these Siddhants. If anyone asks you any question, they can ask any question after class there. Gaur Pramanande Hari Gaur Namami Nandana Namami Nandana Namami Nandana Namami Nandana Namami Namami
Namami Nandanam.
Santa Koti Vishnu Gaudara Brahma Jachite
Manu. Stand up, please.
Manu.
Oh, Madhukar Brahmachari. Friend of Krishna, bosom friend of Krishna, Madhukar. Nityananda? Where is Nityananda?
He's rehearsing for a play.
Sam name Nityananda Das. Maharani? Now you can begin.
Just scoot back a little, spin around.
Don't scoot back.
I hit the sun, sorry.
It's okay, I didn't really hurt it.
Oh, Sakhi Radhe, Vrindavan is more glorious than heaven, Vaikuntha, even more glorious than Ayodhya in the Dwapara, because it has been graced with the footprints of Devaki Sutta. Only in this Vrindavan are the peacocks dancing in rhythm to the flute melody of Govinda. Hearing the sound of the flute and seeing the peacocks dancing, all of the birds, animals, and other living entities have become stone. In his commentary on this verse, Sanatana Goswami says that Krishna played Mirdu Mandra on the flute. When rain clouds begin to gather, the sky at once becomes dark, and very softly and slowly thunder comes. When the clouds clash violently, it produces loud thunder and lightning also. But first they produce a very soft and deep thunder. That is called mandra. Krishna produces a similar sound in his flute, but with mirdu, sweetness. The nature of the peacock is such that when it sees the sky darkening and hears thunder, it begins to dance madly. When Krishna entered the forest, what did he see? Giriraj Govardhan, resplendent with creepers, blooming flowers, and ripe fruits. The breeze was blowing very gently, seemingly unable to carry the full weight of the flower's fragrance. Seeing the natural splendor of Vrindavan, desire for pleasure arose in Krishna, and he began to play his flute very softly. Hearing the deep vibration, the peacocks approached and began making their kikar sound. They saw that Krishna appears like a dark rain cloud. The peacocks circled around Krishna and began dancing with great bhav to the flute melody. One peacock began to think, "Oh, Krishna is playing such a beautiful melody. Dancing to that, we peacocks are experiencing great ananda. I wish I had something to offer him. I have no valuable ornaments. I am simply an animal. But my feathers are valuable. Nothing in this world can compare to their beauty. Maybe I can offer one to him." And thus he left behind one of his feathers. Seeing the feather, Krishna thought, "Oh, this peacock is so loving. He has fully appreciated my flute playing and has offered me one of his valued feathers." Krishna lifted the feather and placed it on his head and thought, Yes, this life of truth is dear to me. This feather has now become dear to me as well. While walking, resting, dreaming, standing or sitting, I will never abandon it. Wherever I may go in Vraj, I will never abandon the flute or this peacock. The peacock song. Oh, I have left this feather for him. But he didn't merely put it in his pocket. He has placed it on his head, the most valuable of all his bodily parts. Today, my love has become completely successful. This is the origin of the peacock feather and how it became Krishna's most celebrated ornament. If someone offers something with praying, and it is also accepted with praying, then both parties become the tasters of that praying. Hari Bol. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. It is therefore renowned as the Namacharya of the holy name, the Acharya of the chanting of Hare Krishna. Although the most exalted of devotees, he appeared in a Muslim family. To instruct all that devotion to Krishna is not dependent upon guna or karma. Love for Krishna is inherent in all beings, and the process of chanting is available for all, regardless of external circumstances. During the time of this pastime, the Muslims were ruling Bengal and resented that one of their own had taken to the ways of the Hindus. It was in this context, in the town of Puliya, that our drama takes place. Haridas Thakur was absorbed in chanting the holy name. Everywhere he went, people were impressed with his saintly qualities. Throughout the area, he was becoming famous and respected. The growing love of the people for Haridas Thakur enraged the local Muslim ruler, the Qazi.
Now, this man Haridas is becoming too popular with the people. He has rejected his high birth as a Muslim, and has become a Hindu. He wanders around obsessed with his foolish chanting. And the people trust him. I want his activity stopped immediately.
Sentries, go find this Haridas and arrest him. In due course, I will want him brought before me. Go. There he is! Haridas, on the orders of the Qazi, I am placing you under arrest. You can do your chanting in prison. Come with us.
As you wish. Here or anywhere. I will always chant my rounds.
Miserable place. Surely remove all of our suffering.
least here.
Oh, Haridas, just by seeing you, love for Krishna is stirring in our hearts. I am so much pleased to see such genuine devotion. I give you my most heartfelt blessing. My blessing is that you will always remain as you are. Please do not be dejected. My blessing was that you will always remain as you are, but I could never wish you any misfortune. I simply desire that the love you have in your hearts for Krishna will always continue. I do not wish for you to be prisoners forever. Soon you will be released, trust me. And when released, as now, always chant the holy names of the Lord and remember his divine pastimes. In this way, develop a distaste for material life and always be happy in love for Krishna.
Prisoner Haridas, the Nawab wishes to see you. Nawab, here is the prisoner Haridas.
This is not some ordinary prisoner. There is a glow emanating from his body. Please sit down. My dear Haridas, I have heard much about you, but I'm confused. I must inquire for you. What kind of mentality has overcome you? You have the blessing of a Muslim birth. Why do you reject your higher birth and take to the ways of the low-class Hindus? How do you expect to achieve salvation? I've decided to punish you according to the laws of the Quran and thus free you from your sins.
My dear sir, there is only one God for all living entities. The difference between the Muslim God and the Hindu God is a name only. According to every scripture, God is one, and he resides in everyone's heart. He is always controlling every living entity, and every living entity is moved by his will. If another living entity hates or envies another person, it actually reflects on his feelings towards the Lord. My dear respected sir, please consider what I have to say seriously. And then, if you still find me guilty, then you may punish me.
Almost everyone present was sincerely moved by the presence and sincere words of Haridas Thakur. But his wisdom could not penetrate the heart of the Qazi, who turned to the Nawab and instructed,
"Punish this man. He is evil and mischievous. He will influence others to become sinful like himself. If he wishes to be excused, then let him preach from the Quran."
My dear friend, please speak from your own scripture. Then you'll have nothing to fear. Otherwise, the Qazi will force me to punish you. You will be reviled and insulted. Please let us avoid this.
Everything God wants will happen. There is no way we can stop that. You are just a mere instrument of the Lord's desire. Even if my body is cut into pieces and I lose my own life, I will never give up the chanting of the holy name of the Lord.
Qazi, what is your decision about it?
Lash him through 22 marketplaces until he dies. There is no other proper judgment. If he lives despite this, then we'll know that our big scholar has spoken the truth.
Thank you.
For Kazi's envious designs had fructified in the heart of the Nawan. Haridas was dragged from one marketplace to the next and to the next. They beat him mercilessly, their black hearts consumed by hate for this pure devotee. But Haridas was a pure soul, completely surrendered to the Lord. So he faithfully chanted Lord Krishna's names. So absorbed was Haridas Thakur in this fervent chanting that he felt no pain. His only concern was compassion for the centuries, despite their piteous lashing of Srila Haridas Thakur.
Oh Krishna, please forgive these poor fallen souls. Do not punish them because of me.
Don't ask for mercy. We'll do our duty to the end.
We have a number of marketplaces left. Which one will you die in, my friend?
Finally, they arrived at the 22nd marketplace.
How can a human being survive such a brutal beating? Any ordinary man would have died after two or three beatings.
We've lashed him continuously throughout 22 marketplaces, but still, he shows no signs of pain or death. Occasionally, he even smiles at us.
He must be a saintly person. Oh, Haridas, because of you, we shall certainly be punished. When the Kazi sees we have failed to kill you, he'll kill us instead.
If my survival brings you such terrible misfortune, then I will definitely give up my body. Just see me die. Hare Krishna.
Haridas immediately fell into a trance. Being a pure devotee, he possessed all mystic power, so he fell lifeless, without a trace of breath.
Oh, our lives have been spared. Let us take his body to the Nawa.
Here is the body of Haridas. Bury his body immediately. No! If he is buried, he will be saved and ultimately go to heaven. Since he chose to act like a Hindu, throw his body into the Ganga so he can suffer eternally like all the other lost Hindus.
The sentries picked up Haridas' body and carried him to the Ganga. Haridas remained in deathly trance, meditating on the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The spirit of Lord Krishna then descended into the body of Haridas. He had already drowned in an ocean of love for Lord Krishna and had no perception of the world around him or where he was. Eventually, Haridas floated downstream on the currents of the Ganga. After some time, he became conscious of the grace of Lord Krishna. Fully awakened and overwhelmed with ecstasy, he climbed the bank of the Ganga and proceeded towards Puliya, loudly chanting the holy name of Krishna as he walked. When the Muslims saw him, they became convinced of his extraordinary mystic powers. Their envy and hate were removed, and they began to worship him as a saintly person. The Nawab, having been informed of Haridas' mystic powers, soon came to see him and appeared before him. Haridas stopped chanting and smiled compassionately at the Muslim ruler, who stood respectfully with folded hands and began to speak in a humble voice.
I can now understand you are truly a simple person. You are seeing the one supreme Lord everywhere and in everything. I have come to beg forgiveness for this offense I have committed. You are a free man in every respect. Please forgive
those of us who have committed this great offense. I do not take any offense. As I have said before, every living entity moves by the will of Krishna. Please chant the holy names of the Lord and remember his pastimes. And in this way, always be happy for love of Krishna. Hari Bol.
Everyone, whether elevated or wretched, forgets about mundane life when he sees the lotus feet of Srila Haridas Thakur. The Muslims had wanted to kill him, but were transformed and worshipped his feet, accepting him as a holy man. After forgiving and blessing them, Haridas proceeded toward Puliya, with the holy name resounding from his lips. O devotees of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the glories of Haridas Thakur are unlimited and unfathomable. By remembering his pastimes, especially the terrible suffering at the hands of the Muslims, one can be delivered and blessed with the benediction of progressing on the path of love for Krishna. Haridas Thakur did not have to accept the punishment at the hands of the Muslims, but he did so to show all people, in all times, in all circumstances, that whatever suffering may come our way, one should always chant the holy name of Lord Krishna. Namacharanju Srila Haridas Thakur Ki Jai. Thank you.
control. How so early you came? Long distance?
Gurudev, is Artik's...
What will be after 3 days? Today Gopinath is not coming?
He's outside waiting
for you. Oh, waiting? Your daughters are okay?
Yes.
They are happy here?
Very happy.
Playing here, there?
They want to stay here.
Oh dear. Can we give you a good sign?